Texas Tech is becoming a popular destination for many high school seniors, with the university growing year after year. Coming up, we'll tell you about another group of students that are adding to the population by continuing their education as a Red Raider.
With Thanksgiving just right around the corner, many students are taking the thought of a holiday meal for granted, but not everyone is so lucky. Find out how one campus group is asking for your help to make sure all students have something to eat over the break.
And the Red Raider volleyball team is finishing up their run in conference play by breaking a recent losing streak. MCTV's Brogan Stewart has the details on the team's latest win, along with a look around Tech Athletics and Sports.
This is the MCTV Weekday Update.
Welcome to the Monday edition of MCTV Weekday Update. I'm Aditya Sahasrabudhe, and you can also call me AD.
And I'm Berkeley Adams. Every year, Texas Tech population continues to grow as more and more students choose to be a Red Raider.
That's right, Berkeley. Even though most of that growth comes from freshmen entering their first year of college, there's also a large number of students that transfer in from other colleges and universities. And this morning, the process of transferring from one neighboring state got a lot easier. Earlier today, administrators from Texas Tech and New Mexico Junior College officially announced a new partnership between the two schools. Both schools signed a memorandum of understanding during a special press conference held in the McKenzie Market Alumni Center at 10 a.m. this morning. The MOU establishes an agreement allowing NMJC students majoring in animal sciences to transfer to Tech and retain most of their credit courses. The MOU also sets up a degree plan that will help students planning to attend Texas Tech know which courses they should take while in junior college. Although today's agreement only applies to the current animal science degree, the MOU will also help students transfer into Tech's new School of Veterinary Medicine once it is formally established. With today's signings, NMJC students planning to attend Tech can plan on transferring most of their hours as early as next semester.
With Thanksgiving only 3 days away, many students are planning to head home to enjoy a feast with their families. But one campus group wants to remind you that there are students who may go hungry this holiday. Raider Ed's Food Pantry is currently accepting donations heading into the Thanksgiving and Christmas breaks. The Food Pantry is an on-campus option for students who are struggling with food insecurity. The pantry is asking for donations of non-perishable items to be distributed to students between now and the end of the semester. Donations can be dropped off directly at the pantry located in room 117 in Docal. Donations can also be brought to the sub room 201. This week, the pantry will only be open today and Wednesday from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., but the pantry will be open daily after the Thanksgiving break through the finals. Also right now, if you live in a TTU resident hall, University Student Housing is hosting a food drive to benefit the food pantry. Residents can donate to the drive by dropping off donations at the front desk. For more information on Raider Red's Food Pantry, including a list of needed items, visit foodpantry.ttu.edu.
Tomorrow is the last day of classes before Thanksgiving break, and most students already have plans to leave campus. But if you are running behind and don't have transportation, there's still an option left for you to get home for the holiday. Tickets are currently available for the Thanksgiving Break Shuttle bus trips. Break Shuttle is a company that partners with parent and family relations to offer trips from campus to several Texas cities. Destinations for this year's Break Shuttle include Austin, Dallas, El Paso, Houston, and San Antonio. Last-minute tickets prices are $109 one-way for Austin, El Paso, and San Antonio, $103 to or from Dallas, and $119 per ticket for Houston. All of the buses leave from the band lot behind the music building at 9 a.m. on Wednesday morning, and the return shuttle leaves from each of the destination cities on Sunday morning. Tickets are also currently available for the winter break trip, which is scheduled to leave after finals on Wednesday, December 13th. For more information on both the Thanksgiving and winter break trips, visit breakshuttle.com. It was another chilly weekend here on South Plains after a cold front moved in on Saturday afternoon.
That's right, AD. Temperatures dropped below freezing on both Saturday and Sunday night, and yesterday's highs only reached the upper 30s. We're already seeing a rebound in temperatures today, but can we expect any more changes heading into the Thanksgiving holiday? Let's take a look at the MCTV forecast. The MCTV Tower Cam is showing clear skies and lots of sun this afternoon. We haven't seen any clouds today, which has been a nice change from yesterday's winter-like conditions. Temperatures have also been a bit warmer, with highs climbing into the mid-50s. But after sunset, we will see a return of colder temperatures with an overnight low dropping into the 20s. Tomorrow, it looks like we can expect a repeat of today's mild weather with more sun and highs back in the 50s. Tomorrow night will also be a little warmer, with temperatures expected to stay above the freezing mark. On Wednesday, we'll see another day of mild temperatures, but we'll also see a return of cloudy skies until mid-afternoon. On Thanksgiving, it looks like we can expect another mild day, but we'll see a lot more clouds. Temperatures will stay in the upper 40s and mid-50s most of the day, and the forecast is calling for a mild evening with lows only dropping into the 40s overnight. Shoppers who are planning to get up early for Black Friday sales will be waking up to mild temperatures with highs climbing to 60 degrees by noon. Temperatures will continue to increase into the mid-60s before sunset, making for a nice afternoon. Heading into the weekend, we'll continue to see a warming trend with another day of temperatures in the 60s. There's even a chance highs could reach the 70 degree mark late Saturday afternoon. But early Sunday morning, a cold front will return to the area, and it looks like temperatures will drop back into the 40s for most of the day. Looking ahead, Sunday's cooler temperatures could lead to a cool week ahead as students return to campus.
Since it's a holiday week, there's not much going on around campus. But before the university shuts down for the break, there's one activity planned this evening that will honor a group of people whose lives ended way too soon. The annual Trans Remembrance Vigil and Celebration of Life is scheduled for tonight at 7 p.m. in the Kent Hans Chapel. During the vigil, members of the Texas Tech and Lubbock communities will come together to honor the lives of transgender people who died due to fatal violence over the past year. During the ceremony, students from the Texas Tech School of Music will perform several selections, and transgender members of the local community will offer comments and reflections on those who tragically lost their lives. Tonight's event is free and open to the public.
Although tonight's vigil is the only event scheduled on campus, there's other options to spend your time until you can leave campus. World War I in West Texas, A Glimpse, is currently on the display in the Southwest Collections Special Collections Library. The exhibit contains letters, booklets, postcards, photographs, and military documents all relating to World War I. The display also showcases several posters from wartime that encouraged Americans to enlist in the military. Other documents included in the exhibit focus on West Texas residents who made the ultimate sacrifice while serving their country. All of the artifacts are part of a much larger collection of materials relating to World War I that are stored in the SWC. If you would like to see the exhibit in person, just plan on stopping by the Southwest Collection Rotunda between now and June of 2019. The SWC is open year-round, but the building will be closed during the Thanksgiving holiday.
The Texas Tech football team headed north to face Kansas State over the weekend. The Red Raiders had hoped to score a win against the Wildcats and secure a chance at a postseason bowl opportunity.
Unfortunately, things did not go Tech's way, and the team is still hoping for one more win. MCTV's Brogan Stewart has a look at the past weekend's game and what's next in store for the Red Raiders in sports. Brogan?
Thanks, Berkeley and AD. This past weekend has been one of ups and downs for the Red Raider programs. The biggest down, most people would agree, was the Red Raiders' loss at Kansas State Saturday. The game started with everything going the good guys' way. However, after the first quarter's conclusion, Kansas State took the wheel and left Tech in the dust. The team looked the worst it had all season. Jet Duffy only threw for 150 yards with no touchdowns and one pick. The run game also never got off the ground with only 31 yards for the whole game. The only points scored came from Clayton Hatfield's two first quarter field goals. These two field goals break the school record Hatfield had previously set with 12 straight makes for the Red Raider place kicker. The team would fall 21-6 to the Wildcats. Tech continues to look for one more win to become bowl eligible with one game left against Baylor next Saturday at 11 in Dallas at AT&T Stadium. However, the bigger question is that with the loss to K-State, is Cliff's job in jeopardy? Who knows? But this weekend's game will possibly be the decision maker if the choice has not already been made. Not all was bad in Manhattan, Kansas this weekend for the Tech Athletics, as the volleyball team was able to pull off the regular season sweep of the K-State Wildcats 3-1. The push was led by freshman Brooke Canis once again, who has been one major player for the Red Raider team. Canis tallied 19 kills and 2 blocks. Another huge player for the team was able to break a season mark in the match. Senior Missy Owens passed the 1,000 assists on the season. This is the third straight year Owens has passed the 1,000 assist mark. The team looks to improve on their 6-8 conference record on Wednesday against the Longhorns of Texas at 6 p.m. in the USA. The Tech soccer team ended their season in devastating fashion in Waco against the number 12 Virginia Cavaliers in the second round of the NCAA tournament. The team gave them all they wanted, shutting them down for 110 minutes of play. However, in penalty kicks, the Red Raiders would fall 4-2, ending their season. The Cavs came into this game as one of the top 10 teams in scoring throughout the season, and the Red Raiders shut them out along with some amazing blocks by Red Raider goalkeeper Marissa Zucchetto, who will be returning next season as a junior. The Red Raiders soccer team will be saying goodbye to 7 seniors, including co-captain Carly Wickenheiser, who has accumulated 83 appearances, which is the most of anyone on the active roster. Good luck to all these ladies as they go on to either continue their career as athletes or move into the professional world of their choosing. On the hardwood, the men's basketball team received some major help for next season with 4 commits putting pen to paper with them signing their national letter of intent. The first of the recruits is 6'6 Kevin McCullers Jr. and will come from San Antonio Wagner High School. He is listed in ESPN's top 30 national players and a 4-star prospect. The next signee, Jemias Ramsey, is the highest ranked recruit and is 6'4 coming out of Duncanville High School. Ramsey is also a 4-star player, but is the 5th ranked player in his position nationally and the 3rd ranked player in Texas. Tech also had 7-foot center Russell Tetua signed from the Putnam Science Academy and also had the transfer 4-star forward Khalid Thomas from the College of Southern Idaho sign as well. All these players will join the team next year. However, you do not have to wait long to see Red Raider basketball in action as they play USC tonight in the College Hall of Fame Classic at the Sprint Center in Kansas City. The game will tip at 8:30 and can be seen on ESPN2. Speaking of Kansas City, former Tech quarterback Patrick Mahomes will be taking on the 9-1 LA Rams tonight at 7:15 on ESPN. This game has 2 very explosive offenses going up against 2 suboptimal defenses. Pat will try to keep the Chiefs' 9-1 season going on the road in LA after the facilities in Mexico were not up to the NFL standard. Well, that's all for sports. Back to you, AD, in Berkeley.
Thanks, Brogan. So, Berkeley, what are you doing for the Thanksgiving break?
Well, because home for me, so I'm just heading down the road to my house.
That's great. That's all for today's edition of the MCTV Weekday Update.
Thanks so much for joining us, and be sure to check out ttuhub.net every day for more news. Have a happy Thanksgiving, and we'll see you next week.